The energy sector is rapidly transforming. Renewables are expected to surpass coal as the top global electricity source by 2025, with solar leading the way. Today, solar energy generates over 6% of U.S. electricity, with a target to reach 30% by 2030, creating new opportunities to drive the transition to a low-carbon future.
Energy is the backbone of economic development, security, health, prosperity, and solar is the key to unlock this. We can create this access to low-cost energy that's very affordable and very reliable, because this will change the world.
In a special Washington Post Live Climate program, global leaders and innovators gather to discuss the future of renewables, the policies needed to improve grid resiliency, and the emerging innovations that are shaping the new energy era.
Hanwha Qcells is doing something that has never been done before here in the United States. You're putting almost the entire solar supply chain under one roof. Why take on something so ambitious?
We're investing in solar because it's the fastest growing, lowest cost source of energy today. We're on track to bring Qcells' annual solar production capacity in the U.S. to 8.4 gigawatts by the end of the year, which is around enough to power about 1.3 million homes annually. Ultimately, we see solar as the key to building a sustainable future, and we want to build that future right here in America.
Having every aspect of the manufacturing process in one location, how is it impacting innovation?
Innovation is always driven by learning rates. So having a streamlined supply chain means that we can connect the dots, enabling innovation at scale. So we also can then bring these new technologies to market more quickly.
You've been in the renewable energy industry for more than 20 years. You've seen it evolve. Where could the government do more?
We need to see our nation's trade laws enforced to make sure that domestic producers have a level playing field to compete on. And we need a provision to be implemented that supports domestically manufactured wafers and cells. So this is the only way we'll be able to see continued progress in bringing this vital industry back to the U.S.
Tell us about your commitment to spurring the energy transition.
The thing that sets Qcells apart is the breadth of our innovation in this realm. So in addition to building the technology in our factories, we're helping develop, design, and even build large systems for utilities to help them lower costs to their customers, and more importantly, increase the resilience of our network. So we're really excited about the future of solar, and the possibilities here are limitless.